Hi guys, my name is Robert Feranek, and in this video I'm going to show you the really interesting stuff about how a multi-layer PCB is built. There are three basic ingredients which you need to build a multi-layer PCB. This is the first one. It's called core, and it is actually isolation with copper on one side and copper on the other side. This is how it looks. They have different thickness, from thick one, really thick one, for really really tiny and thin one. This is the really tiny one. It looks like, or it may look like, it's just copper. It's not copper. There is isolation between two sheets of copper. The other thing which you need to build PCB, the second ingredient, is called prep rack. This is the prep rack. There is no copper on prep rack. It is just isolation. And the third thing is what you need. It's just copper. Now have a look how it's going to build. This guy is going to build a stack up the PCB. What do you think? What is going to be the first layer which he is going to place there? Everyone who think it's copper is right. See, this is the copper. And I will move it a little bit ahead. And so we can see the second layer. It's the isolation, it's the prep rack. On this one, he's placing core. You see, there is copper on the bottom, isolation, copper on the top. This is the core with two layers of your PCB. How does he know what he needs to build? He has it on his computer. You can see it here. See, this is what he is building now. He knows exactly how many sheets, what is the thickness of the prep rack. He's putting it here. Another core. What will be the next sheets of prep rack? I think it's like four sheets of prep rack. Almost done, almost done. Two more layers on this core, and on the top of the core we need to place isolation again. He's cleaning the surface. Now he's going to place the prep rack. Okay. And now the last layer. What is the last layer? It's the copper. Yes, it is here. On top of this, he will place a metal plate, and let's see, let's wait when he's going to place it there, so you can see it. This is the plate, and then it goes into oven. This is the oven. Here on this bottom side you can see big doors, and when these big doors, they will close. Here between these plates there will be the PCBs what he just made between these plates. So when the doors will close, all the air will be removed, so there will be vacuum. these plates, they will heat up and they will make pressure on the PCB, and you actually make the PCB in this oven. So it's PCB oven. How the motif of the PCB is transferred on the copper. There are more techniques. This one, which you can see here, it's a standard way which you can use at home. It is PCB with photosensitive layer on top of it, and they place film, standard film, on the PCB. You can see it here. And then they expose this to the light. That's pretty standard stuff. Now the really interesting stuff. I didn't know this. When they do the plating, you know, when they connect the via inside with copper, they do it in two steps. First, they put there only very, very small, thin copper with one process or one technology, and then they put there a bigger copper with something different, different technological process. And the thing what I didn't know was on top of this, they put tin. You can see it here on this picture. This is actually the website of the PCB manufacturer, which I visited, PCB1.com. And here you can see, here is the PCB after the plating, still with the mask, without the tin. Now they put their tin, see, here is the tin, and they will remove the mask. See, here is not the mask. Why? What do you think why? Or what is going to happen? They put this PCB into special stuff which will remove only the copper. Yeah? So after, when they remove it from this stuff, this copper is not here, but the tin, it is still there. And then in next step, they will remove the tin, and after they remove the tin, they have nice PCB. I really didn't know this. That was really very interesting. This is a picture of microvia where you can see the very thin of copper here. See? And this is the big copper here. Very nice. Now the question is, what I ask, how do you know how deep you are going to drill this hole? Another interesting stuff. Here you can see the drilling machine. Now it's going to change a tool. You can see a lot of tools here. It's changing now. And before it starts drilling, it will check the tool. Know how it is placed, if everything is okay. Now it's checking the tool, and the trick how it knows how deep it is drilling is, I will wait when it starts drilling so you can see it. It's drilling now, and the trick is actually knows when it touches the top of the PCB, and then it starts measuring. Really simple trick. As you can see, there is something on top of the PCB. It's a plate which actually helps to make the drilling more precise, and it actually takes heat away from the tool. They have actually a lot of videos, quite interesting videos on their website. Go on this address and you can watch their videos here. They explain how it is done. They have also a YouTube channel. You can see all the processes here if you are interested. I hope you found this video useful, and don't forget to check out our other videos. So, see you soon!